Alright everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So today, I'm going to be trying to extract platinum from spark plugs. I have a whole bunch of spark plugs here that I've collected from junkyards that I've been going to. You see, spark plugs are laying around the junkyard all the time because people take them out of the engine block to look inside the cylinder to see how well the engine was running and see the condition of the engine block is before they purchase it. And usually the spark plugs end up on the ground, and eventually they would just get thrown away. So while I'm walking around the junkyard, I occasionally pick up a few.
So I've sorted the spark plugs that I've kept into three main categories. These over here actually say platinum on them. These here say iridium. And these over here don't actually say any precious metal. But if you look closely at the tip, it actually looks like it does contain some sort of precious metal there. So I still might be able to recover something from it. My guess is these could actually be palladium. Or they're just unmarked platinum. The ones that just had the copper are just still sitting at the junkyard.
So to get the platinum out of these, I'm gonna start by cutting off this little thing here. Just like that. And this actually contains a little spot of platinum on it as well, I think. Yes, so I will be keeping that. And also this other contact down in here. See, there it is. I'll be keeping that as well. Those are the parts that are going to contain the platinum. The rest of this is really just steel and ceramic.
The reason that we use platinum in the spark plugs is simply because platinum is a very resistant metal. Copper would actually be worn away over time by the sparks, as the sparks are extremely hot plasma and they actually eat away at the metal because it's basically vaporizes it when it touches it. Copper will handle it for a while, maybe after a few tens of thousands of miles, but platinum can handle the sparks for a very long time before the spark gap actually changes significantly. So long, in fact, that the platinum spark plugs usually outlast the car. See, the gap between the positive and negative terminals on the spark plug need to be very precise. If they're a little bit off, the spark will either be too small to ignite the gas, or the gap will be too big for the spark to even happen at all. If the spark gap is not right, the engine won't run properly. And if your metal is being eroded by the spark, then the spark gap will be constantly changing, which is not a good thing to have happen.
So here's all the little platinum points from 20 or so spark plugs. Now I'm just going to put these in acid to dissolve away the base metals.
Some nitric acid should make short work of those pieces of metal, but it won't touch the platinum. So while that's dissolving, I think I may as well process these other spark plugs here and extract the iridium and palladium from them.
So there's the contacts from the iridium spark plugs. I managed to save 6 of them. I think I started with 7. One of them got lost. Here's the ones from the unknown spark plugs. Now these may contain palladium, so I can't use nitric acid on these. I'll have to use hydrochloric acid, which will dissolve them much more slowly, but that'll keep the palladium from being dissolved by the nitric acid. Iridium, there are no acids that dissolve it, so I should be able to use the nitric on this just fine.
So here we are after several days in the acid, and I believe I've removed most of the base metals. See, here's my platinum pieces. Zoom in on these so you can see what shape they're in. There you go. There's some like little pieces of wire, but mostly like these little round blobs of platinum. And I think there's actually a couple of pieces of stainless steel in there still that was not able to be dissolved by the acid. Here's the pieces from the spark plugs that I thought might be palladium. The acid took a lot longer to dissolve these, as I expected. In fact, a lot of the pieces I just had to pull out after the metal fell off of them. Here, of course, is the iridium pieces. So now I think it's time that I dissolve the platinum into aquariga so that I can finish purifying it and hopefully make some pure platinum bead that we can weigh. The palladium, I'm just going to add some nitric acid to this and see if it actually is palladium. If it is palladium, the nitric acid should begin dissolving it almost right away. And if nitric acid doesn't dissolve it, then it probably actually is platinum. Alright, there's the acid. I don't see any reaction, but I'll give it a few minutes. So I've given it some time in a bath of hot water, and it doesn't appear like it's reacted with it at all. That means I don't actually have palladium here.
I think it's kind of weird that they wouldn't mark the platinum spark plugs. I think that would be a selling feature, right? But apparently some of them they don't mark. So I'll just mix this in with my platinum. I'm actually going to just mix them all together. Okay, so I just put in a little bit of hydrochloric acid. Now, aquariga does dissolve platinum, but very slowly at room temperature. If I warm it up, I can increase the rate significantly. Looks like the platinum is beginning to dissolve. The solution's turning red as the platinum goes into solution. I think that over there that's bubbling furiously is actually some of the stainless steel that was left. It shouldn't hurt things too bad. Update number two. It appears that all of the stainless steel is now gone. And you don't see any visible bubbles. That's because the platinum just dissolves so slowly. So it's been a little bit more than an hour since my last cut. I put this on there to conserve nitric acid so it didn't all evaporate away. See what we got? Nice red liquid. Pretty sure all the... Ooh, that's warm. Let me get something to... Pretty sure all of the platinum should be dissolved by now. So let's pour this off. Hopefully retain the iridium. I'll give this a little bit of a rinse later, but yeah, there's the iridium and a little bit of probably some metallic oxides that didn't dissolve. So there's actually quite a few little pieces of metal in there. There's definitely a lot of the platinum ones that are dissolved, but a lot of those that I thought were palladium at first must have actually been iridium. Cool. I got more iridium than I thought I would. So I put this large bottom dish with the platinum back into the crock pot to evaporate it dry. This is to actually get rid of all of the nitric acid. Most of it's probably already gone, but let's get rid of it for good. Now that the platinum solution is completely dried out, I can turn it back into platinum metal. So now I've reconstituted the platinum with some water to get it to dissolve into liquid form again. I'm going to transfer it over into this steeper sided container. And now to precipitate out the platinum, I'm going to add in a little bit of ammonium chloride, which I've dissolved into a little bit of water here. Now I just let the platinum ammonium chloride settle out of solution. Now that I've given it a few minutes to settle out, we should be left with a yellow precipitate on the bottom. So the solution here is still a bit orange. Now that could be either that it's got a little bit of platinum left in it, or it has something to do with the stainless steel that was dissolving earlier. So here's my platinum ammonium chloride on a piece of paper, as I just filtered it out. Now let's put it inside this crucible. I'm gonna add a little bit of borax and a little bit of litharge, or lead oxide. If you guys have seen my precious metal refining series, you guys will know that I use this a lot to collect together the small amount of precious metals into a workable metal bead. Well, that's cooking. Let's see if we can melt down this iridium. You're gonna have to use a torch to do it because iridium has a very high melting point. I'm not even sure if I can do it. Well, I actually wasn't able to melt it. That iridium is just too hard to melt. Or my torch is just not good enough. So here's our crucible with the lead platinum alloy. Let's pour it off. Okay. That looks good. Now to remove the platinum from the lid, I'm gonna add it to a cupel and put it back in the furnace. Let's see what we got in here. It's warm. There it is. There's our platinum. Now it's not going to be quite done because 2000 degrees Fahrenheit is not hot enough to melt the platinum. So I'm actually going to hit this with a torch real quick to melt it, and that'll drive off the rest of the lead. And instead of being like a little pile of platinum powder, it should be a solid bead. Well, it's a little bit smaller and a little bit less shiny, but it should be pure platinum now. So here are the iridium wires from the spark plugs. Let's see how much they weigh. Set them over here on the scale. Okay, have them go everywhere, but they're on the plate.
26 milligrams. That's not very much, and it's even less because iridium's incredibly dense. Let's tear this. Now I've got my platinum bead in these calipers here. As you can see, it's 1.5 millimeters wide. Let's actually put this on the scale and see what it weighs. There it is. 40 milligrams. I was hoping to get a little bit more, but I suppose that is right about 2 milligrams per spark plug, which seems reasonable. Anyway, hope y'all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.